and wacky things that happened at Universal Studios Orlando this week? Well, come adventure with me, for I am Winu, your weekly Universal news and updates. But let's not continue on with an intro and get straight into my first topic. Construction, a topic that has a surprising amount of fire this week. So this week, a fire caught on the current construction site of Popeye's Builder at Burgess. This was due to a pump that was unfilling the water, overflowing, and causing a small flash fire. However, this fire was put out in moments with an extinguisher. This was done while there was maintenance being done to the ride, so nobody was hurt in this process that we know of, and no guests were on the site. So we're pretty sure most people are safe, and it was just a flash fire and nothing crazy to be worried about. So this week, the Velocicoaster tested with people on it. This is nothing crazy from what we've seen so far, but it's good to see that they're still doing testing with actual people. Also, with a bit of a smaller update, the baby raptor cutout on one of the Velocicoaster construction wall gate paddock entrance things was removed. As for the other fire, a fire effect was seen at the entrance of the Velocicoaster, illuminating the raptors. This looks super cool, and I don't know if it's meant to be like a Jurassic Park torch effect or whatever, but I like it. It looks fun. Also, an archway was seen being built on this site. I'm pretty sure that this is just have to do with the queue, but we can see it, so yay. Also, one of the raptors had some of its plastic cut off and then resealed, so nothing really too crazy happened to this raptor. It wasn't wrapped, just cut open, basically. Also, planter walls were painted brightly, more likely for the preparation of the Velocicoaster. This also came with some fresh paint jobs on other planters. This is just cool, and we can see that they're getting ready to open the Velocicoaster, and with summer approaching faster and faster, I'm really excited to see when this opens. However, it's going to take us a while to actually get an opening date, but let's have our fingers crossed that it'll be soon. So also in Jurassic news, the Jurassic Outfitters sign has the word Outfitters removed, and also it had the skull in the middle being removed. All of this is here normally, as you can see here. However, this is just so a better looking sign can replace it. Not that no big change are going to be happening to the store. They're just replacing the sign. Also, on Wednesday, the Hulk closed for unknown reasons, and work was visible by the Cobra Roll. This is just interesting to see, and we also have no clue why it was. However, it would just reopen later that day, so obviously whatever happened was more than likely unexpected because of how fast the ride went back up. Finally, the Hush-A-Bomb Plunger was returned instead of being a wooden box. So, yay, it's now touchable, I guess? I don't know how to feel, or I don't know. Photo op is back. Yay! So, there was a bunch of serious news in this topic, but I think it's about time I show you some silly news in my next topic. Neural news, which is currently a very funny topic, but also is the start of a line of very short ones. So, this week, a TikToker filmed themselves going under the restraints and slapping an animatronic on the Great God's line queue. I don't really know how to feel about this, because they could have very easily broken it, and obviously this is directly against the rules, and from what we can tell that there's no repercussions. However, I do have to say it takes some guts to do something like that in a place that is as secure as Universal Studios is. I have to say though, I'm probably on the more upset side, because the animatronic could have broken, which would have been extremely expensive for Universal to fix, and could also lead to them not allowing animatronics in Gringotts, and nobody would really want that. So, sorry for ranting about, you know, me getting frustrated, but whatever. Also this week, the parks hit capacity twice. They both hit capacity at 3 p.m. on Saturday, but also hit capacity at 2:45 on Sunday. However, on Sunday, the parks would reopen, unlike Saturday. This is all kind of crazy, and it turns out that Valentine's Day is a place to spend Universal, as we can tell from these crowds. Speaking of big crowds, we can see what draws big crowds into the parks in my next topic. items went down in price. This just makes things cheaper, and it probably has to do with the fact that Universal realized that people were getting more expensive stuff with the food pass than they would like it to be charged, or people just weren't buying it. Either way, it's down in price, save your dollar, it is now cheaper. Finally, more menus and registers were placed at some booths. This is just so that the booths can have more people and can move faster, and it makes everything more efficient. So speaking of booths, we can see what the booths sell in other details in my next topic. Food and restaurants, and I actually only have one update in this topic. This is that the Germany stand now sells a meat bratwurst. Previous to this, they had only sold a vegan bratwurst, so it's fun to see that this is here. So speaking of the things that are fun to see, we can take a look at my next topic. Merchandise! And this week, something that's not expected is in this topic. That is that this week, Universal started something called Universal Pay. This is a feature on the app in the wallet section that allows you to pay in any Universal store touchlessly. It uses the information of a credit or a debit card, and when you go to make a purchase, asks you to confirm your PIN. It then loads a unique QR code for the staff to scan. This is really cool, and it's quite fancy, I have to say. I would never think of making unique QR codes, but good job Universal for this one. Also, this app allows you to base a budget per day, which is extremely helpful as it's easy to overspend in parks like Universal. However, knowing how much you need to spend and it not allowing you to spend more is good if you're with a family or just don't want to spend too much yourself. Also, the entire 2020 Retro line was brought back as a classic souvenir. I don't know if it's cheaper or more expensive or the same price, however, it is back, so if you want to buy it, now is your chance. Also, Earl the Squirrel merchandise was found in the Port of Entry Christmas shop. This is also kind of another throwback thing. Earl the Squirrel is probably one of my favorite Christmas event things ever, so if I were in the parks now, I'd totally go back and buy him. Finally, the online store added a chocolate frog ornament. It's a little bit late to get it for Christmas, however, you can definitely get it for next one. So that's everything that I could find in Universal Studios Orlando this week. I hope you have a fun time watching my video, and if you did, please consider leaving a like and or subscribing. It helps me out a lot. But now that all of that is said and done, thank you for watching, and this is Wunu, signing off.